Since the mid-90s, the period Earth Report has been on air, an area of forest within the tropics larger than Western Europe has been cleared, mainly for small plots, for industrial farming and timber. For fear of losing viewers, natural history filmmakers are reluctant to tell the story of how we've reached the point where the pace of extinction is 1,000 times what scientists describe as the background rate. This week in Blood Timber, we begin coverage in a series of Earth Reports that will take us to the embattled rainforests around the world. We will ask, what future for conservation and forest people in states where corruption is rampant? We'll show how, despite the awareness in the rich world, its consumers continue to buy the goods, hardwood, soya and palm oil, that are levelling the forest. And while recognising the need for conservation groups and aid agencies to garnish a diet of bad news with good news, we'll ask if the public is being greenwashed. Our first programme comes from Cameroon in Central Africa. Consistently coming out in the watchdog Transparency International's assessments as one of the most corrupt countries in the world, it's been a graveyard for well-meaning attempts to conserve the forest, the home of the Baka pygmies. These people are unloading sacks of meat, bushmeat poached from the forest. Deliveries happen every day. It's contrary to a loan agreement with the World Bank. It's against the law, but not a policeman in sight. The meat of endangered species is sold openly for food in the markets of the capital, Yaoundé. Along roads carved out by the timber companies, commercial poachers are creating the phenomenon of silent forests. The forests that for millennia have supported the Baka are now emptying. Primate meat is particularly favoured by the Bantu, and consumers seem unaware of any threat to the great ape's survival. The bushmeat trade is thriving. And it's not only the wildlife, but the Baka, or pygmies, who are threatened. Along with forest peoples throughout the world, their culture and way of life is disappearing with the trees and wildlife. What's happening here is not only against the country's laws, it runs counter to an impressive-sounding rota of international agreements to protect the rights of indigenous peoples. The world of the pygmies has literally been swallowed up, leaving them without land rights, livelihoods, or citizenship. The Baka are forest-dwelling hunter-gatherers. It's believed they're the first inhabitants of the rainforests of Central Africa. For countless generations, they saw themselves as guardians of the forest. Hunting was a cooperative venture between a number of families. No one man or family held authority or a position of leadership over the others, and they only killed what they needed to survive. Today, hunting is still very much a way of life. Despite being settled in villages, the Baka see themselves as forest people. Across Central Africa, there are many different pygmy groups, thought to number about 120,000 people. In the most remote areas of the Congo Basin, some are still living a traditional life. But for the Baka of southern Cameroon, almost everything has changed. Speaking 30 years ago, the words of British anthropologist Colin Turnbull are prophetic.
I think the pygmies are doomed. Certainly they are. I don't see any way out of it. We face this question, what can we offer the pygmies that would be of advantage to them, that would make their life better than it is? The answer is nothing. Zero. We can't offer them better health. We can't offer them better food. We can't offer them better living conditions. But they will die genetically, in a sense, as a distinct physical type. But much more serious is the fact that the culture will die.
Yeah. Cameroon, the arrival of large-scale logging industries marked the end of the Baka way of life. Industrial-scale logging operations began just 30 years ago in Baka forests without any consultation with them. Most of that timber has been felled for the European market. The Baka people received no compensation from the profit or revenues raised by the timber trade. As new roads were carved deep into the forest, assertive Bantu people from West Africa, where virtually all the forest has been cleared, have migrated into the forest of the Baka.
Logging attracts thousands of Bantus to remote forest areas, which was the home of the Pygmies. Once the Bantus are there, they dominate Pygmy society. It's very clear cut. So these Pygmies have no longer much of a hope to live the way they used to live, even if they wanted to.
As the forest has opened up to Bantus, so the highly profitable bushmeat trade has escalated. According to a World Bank report, trade in wildlife can yield revenues as high as logging.
So he shot three females, and these two babies were with them hanging on, and they got injured and killed as well. So this is a real massacre, and I think everybody accepts that at this rate, the gorillas will be wiped out here. So these scenarios keep repeating themselves all over and are linked to the logging activities and the logging infrastructure.
With an estimated 1 million tons of bushmeat consumed each year in Central Africa, the overexploitation of the forest makes life even harder for the Baka.
The Baka are left in a terrible position. On the one hand, they're persecuted, stopped, prevented physically, brutally from entering traditional areas of forest where they would go for long journeys and hunting trips. And on the other hand, their resources are being depleted by these elite, local elite level bushmeat traders to appalling extents.
What's happening to the Baka is contrary to virtually every international human rights accord. The Bantu culture clashes with the gentle Baka people, who say they are treated like slaves by them.
On est très calme. Bref, on est trop calme. C'est à partir de là, peut-être qu'ils prennent beaucoup d'avantages. Ces gens-là, ces Bantous-là, ne nous prennent pas en considération. Il y a comme, par exemple, le travail. Un Baka peut aller chez un Bantou travailler. Mais voilà, on va donner à un Baka durant toute la journée. Comme ça, du matin jusqu'à comme ça. On va donner 250. Est-ce que ça, c'est normal? Ce n'est pas normal. On essaie de parler de cela, quand on marque au moins quelque chose, mais ça ne va pas. Toujours, on nous prend comme un esclave. Nous sommes comme les esclaves.
During 3 weeks traveling the roads of southern Cameroon, Earth Report found a number of cases where the rights of Baka people are being flouted. Just outside Yokaduma, all the waste from a nearby town has been dumped at the edge of a Baka village. The inhabitants told Earth Report's crew that the incidence of eye infections and gastric problems have tripled since the rubbish arrived.
Petits enfants partent balayer, ils vont rester, ils vont jouer là sur la saleté, ils ramassent des trucs, des petites choses. Vous savez qu'est-ce que c'est la poubelle? On jette des choses intoxiquées, bon les gens les crachent n'importe quoi, et eux, ils ne savent rien.
Though no independent evaluation is available, Earth Report observed that out of 40 Baka children at the village school, 12 now have eye infections. Living on the edge of the vanishing forest, the Baka here are reliant on streams for their water supply. But the runoff from the rubbish tip is polluting their water.
La poubelle est en train de se verser dans nos sources. et nous buvons l'eau de là et ça peut nous intoxiquer.
They now need to spend what precious little money they have on chlorine to treat the water. The villagers have complained to the town authorities, but so far they say their attempts to get them to remove the waste have come to nothing. This village was burnt a few days earlier by the local authorities. The reason given is that it lies in a designated buffer zone, an area surrounding a national park where no settlement is allowed. Buffer zones are designed to relieve poaching pressure in the park. This is the third time this family has been moved. This is not an isolated incident. Just a few kilometers along the same road, another Baka village has been destroyed.
Ils ont pris le pétrole, mettre sur la toiture, tout la maison brûle. Le jour là, les gens ont dormi deux jours dehors. Il y avait la grande pluie comme ça.
There are no easy answers. Indigenous peoples lay claim to the ancestral right to hunt and live in protected areas. The government in Cameroon says it's trying to address problems of poaching and illegal land use.
Gérer le Baka à part, à l'écart des autres populations, c'est une donnée assez compliquée, mais un effort a été fait pour reconnaître des populations locales dans le cadre des droits d'usage et également les spécificités des groupes endogènes qui sont les Baka.